Good morning, students. Welcome to your class, your English 1 class today. Today I'll be taking a new lesson, that is the Summit Within. In 8B, I had just started yesterday in the live class, but I could not continue with it. So for both of you, B and C, I'm doing it together. So the Summit Within. The lesson name is the Summit Within. And the objective of this lesson is to, as you know, read a text to understand and to identify new words, vocabulary. Please write this down yourself. And one of the most important learning outcome of this is, from this lesson, we learn what willpower is, what endurance is, what hard work is, what persistence is. Persistence means to continue going on in the face of difficulty. Some people, they give up. So this tells us about not giving up and how you will reach your goal. Once you start towards your destination, going towards your goal, you will reach that goal. And that you can achieve only with hard work, with willpower, with endurance, the power to continue, or persistence, keep going. I can do it, I can do it, I can do it. Having that kind of attitude will help you achieve all your goals. Yes. Now, whatever challenges you take up in life, you just can't go halfway and say, I finished, I'm going back. You cannot say that. You need to continue. If you give up halfway, that means you are weak. You need to be powerful, you need to be strong to move ahead in life and to achieve goals that you set for yourself. You set your goals yourself and you need to work towards those goals yourself. Nobody's going to work for you. You have to work yourself. Yes, like for example, you set a goal for yourself, say, I'm going to get 90% in my exam. So that is your goal. And who's going to get you that 90%? Mommy and Papa will get you that 90%? No, there's nobody on earth who will get you that 90% except you. You are the one who can get yourself that goal. So it is keeping that kind of mind. HPS Ahluwalia was able to conquer the summit. Summit here means the mountain, Mount Everest. He was able to conquer Mount Everest, the physical Mount Everest, the mountain Mount Everest. Now he talks about the summit within. The lesson name is the summit within. Now what is this within? Within is something that is inside you. Yes, something that is inside you. Climbing Mount Everest and going through the difficulties of life, like Papa, like your Papa, he's working very hard. So there is a summit within your Papa, that he has to take care of the family. He has to earn money. He has to bring home money to feed you and the family members. So those are summits that your Papa conquers every day he works hard. Yes. So it's about conquering yourself from inside. Getting yourself to win from inside. Not everything is about climbing, physical climbing the Mount Everest. No. It's going through the obstacles of life. Life will throw you so many obstacles. It's like the yesterday I was telling class 8B, like the hurdle race. You know, hurdle race, when they in the sports that we have, athletics, when we have the there, we have 100 meters race, we have 200 meters race, we have 1000 meter race, and one of the races is called the hurdle race, where the runner has to run and jump over some obstacles. Sometimes there are wooden things kept, wooden stairs kept, he has to jump over that. Sometimes there is water, he has to jump over that water. So all this water and these hurdles that are lying in our path, we need to overcome them. And that is conquering yourself. That is a kind of summit, that is a kind of mountain that you are climbing. When you are able to overcome those difficulties and overcome those obstacles, that is your summit within. And when you conquer all those, that makes you happy. You will be as happy as HPS Ahluwalia climbing the Mount Everest. Same, you will get the same feeling. When you do something, when you set out to do something and you are able to accomplish it, achieve it, finish it, complete it till the end, that will give you a sense of exhilaration, happiness, extreme happiness. You will be jubilant, you will feel like shouting, screaming, yes, I have done it. You will feel like that. Yes, you will feel like you're standing on the top of the world, Mount Everest. Same feeling. Now this lesson is about that, and HPS Ahluwalia talks about both conquering the summit, the mountain, the peak, the Everest, as well as conquering the summit inside you, that is inside you. So continue watching the video. If you have any doubts, let me know. Okay, so please watch the video till the end. So today we'll start a new lesson, the summit, by Major HPS Ahluwalia. By Major HPS Ahluwalia.
So in the text is given here what you can see in front of you before you read. So Major H.P.S. Ahluwalia was a member of the first successful Indian expedition to Mount Everest in 1965. The video that I sent you yesterday and that you may have seen in the beginning, that this date is mentioned, 1965. So he was a part of that expedition. Expedition in the sense that he did not climb the summit alone. He did not climb Mount Everest alone. There were a number of people who climbed with him. And so such kind of people, when they go, it's like excursion, no? You go for excursion to a different state, to a different place. This is an expedition, an adventurous expedition going up the Mount Everest. How did he feel when he stood on the highest point in the world? How did this man, H.P.S. Ahluwalia, feel as he was standing on top of the world? Why top of the world? Because it is the highest peak in the world. Let us hear his story in his words. Climbing the summit and then the more difficult task of climbing the summit within. So there are two things that he did here, climbing the summit, that is climbing Mount Everest. And another more very important thing is the more difficult task of climbing the summit within, the summit that is within you, the climb that is within you, inside you. Within means inside. And climbing that inside of you is more difficult than climbing the summit, even more difficult than climbing the highest mountain in the world. I explained to you about the summit within in my introductory video. Hopefully you're watching that as well. Okay, this is the before you read. Now, if you look on the right side of this page on your screen, you will see the words, new words there, surged. Surged means arose suddenly and intensely with great force. It's like the waves, they rise intensely, very with great force. Next is panorama. Panorama is view of a wide area. In some of our phones, we have this panoramic view, isn't it? Full 360 degrees. That is called a panorama. Jubilant means very happy because of success. Because you are successful, so you become very happy. You become jubilant. When you pass your exam with 99-100%, then you become jubilant. Not just happy, but jubilant. Tinge means trace or shade. Like there are some girls who like to, color their hair. Not color their hair completely, but just put streaks of hair, isn't it? Just little bit hair they take and they give it a different color. So we can call that tinge. Or a trace or a shade. That is the meaning. You need to learn the meanings as well as for your spellings. Now begins the lesson. Of all the emotions which surged through me as I stood on the summit of Everest, looking over miles of panorama below us, the dominant one, I think, was humility. So of all the emotions, there are many, many emotions which can come into you when you are successful in doing something. You are happy, you feel like crying, you feel like jumping, you feel like shouting, you feel like screaming. So these are all kinds of emotions that come to you. He says, of all the emotions which surged through me, means many emotions came to him as I stood on the summit of Everest. Now he has already climbed this. He's talking about this. I means H.P.S. Ahluwalia. Looking over miles of panorama. Panorama means looking at the whole area from up there. The dominant one, I think, was humility. So like I told you, he had many emotions. And the dominant one, the most dominant, the most strongest, the highest emotion that he had was that of humility. Humility comes from the word humble, to be humble, not to be proud, not to have too much pride, to be very, very humble. So this is what he felt. This is the emotion that he felt standing there. He felt very, very small. He didn't feel very, very great. He felt extremely small. He felt extremely humble. The physical in me seemed to say, thank God it's all over. The physical in me means because he was very, very tired. It's no joke to be climbing Mount Everest. And so the physical aspect of his body means he was tired. That said to him that thank God it's over. However, instead of being jubilant, there was a tinge of sadness. Instead of being happy that he had accomplished climbing the Mount Everest, there was a slight sadness was there in him. Was it because I had already done the ultimate in climbing and there would be nothing higher to climb and all the roads hereafter would lead down? Now, before coming to the Mount Everest, they had to do a lot of preparations and all that excitement. Like for us also, when we are going for a picnic, for example, we are going for a student picnic. We are all very, very happy. We're shouting, we're screaming for weeks together. We're planning, we're going to wear this, we're going to wear that. Yes, and finally the day comes for your picnic and then you go for the picnic. And coming back home from the picnic is one very, very sad thing. We feel all very down, we feel very low. Going for the picnic, we're shouting, screaming, singing in the bus. But coming back, it's not that much. That much happiness is not there. Why? Because you feel sad. It's over. You think, oh my God, the picnic is over. The same thing he felt. He had done the ultimate in climbing, the ultimate mountain. This is the mountain climbers or mountaineers, they wait a lifetime to climb Mount Everest. And it's because this is the highest peak. Once you have climbed Mount Everest, there is no other peak higher than Mount Everest. Yes, everything becomes very, very easy. So he thought to himself, was this the end of my mountaineering? Was it the end? Because there were no more mountains to climb. This was the highest mountain. So that is why he had a slight sadness was there in him. Because that thought came to him. He had climbed the ultimate mountain in the world. The highest peak in the world. This Mount Everest. By climbing the summit of Everest, you are overwhelmed by a deep sense of joy and thankfulness. Thankfulness towards whom? Towards God, right? So by climbing the summit of Everest, you are overwhelmed. Overwhelmed means happiness and joy overtakes you. You are full of joy. You are full of thankfulness. It is a joy which lasts a lifetime. Till the day you die, that joy will be there with you. That sense of accomplishment. That yes, in my lifetime, I was able to climb Mount Everest. And I have achieved the ultimate climbing success of my life. That is the joy that you feel, and this joy will last a lifetime. The experience changes you completely. The very act of climbing this Mount Everest, it changes you completely as a man. It changes you completely. The man who has been to the mountains is never the same again. You go a different person and you come back down a different person. There, just by climbing the mountain, you learn about life, and it makes you a completely different man. The one going up and the one coming down are two different people from inside. The physical is the same, but from inside you are a changed person. These views given here are all that of Major HPS Ahluwalia. Because maybe he experienced those. No, he climbed the Mount Everest. And this story he wrote through because of his experiences. He learned all these going up the mountain. So he says, as I look back at life after climbing Everest, I cannot help remarking about the other summit, the summit of the mind, no less formidable and no easier to climb. Yes, he talks about the other summit, which is the summit within. As he looks back at life after climbing the Everest, he thinks about the summit within and how we need to climb that summit, the summit of the mind, how we need to overcome our obstacles, how do we fight that. He talks about that after coming down. So in the previous paragraph, we said that the summit of the mind is no less formidable and no easier to climb. No less formidable means no less powerful. It is powerful. Yes. Even when getting down from the summit, once the physical exhaustion had gone, I began asking myself the question why I had climbed Everest. So these are his thoughts. He's saying, even when getting down from the mountain, now once you go up, you have to come down, isn't it? You cannot make your home there. You cannot make your house there. So he says, even when getting down from the summit, once the physical exhaustion had gone, physical exhaustion means the tiredness or the fatigue, the tiredness is gone. I began asking myself the question why I had climbed Everest. What was the reason? What made me climb Everest? This thought came to HPS Ahluwalia. Why did the act of reaching the summit have such a hold on my imagination? Why did I make it such an important part of my life? Why could I not think of anything else? Why did I have to think of climbing Mount Everest only? So these are the questions that arise in him, that come to him as he is coming down. It was already a thing of the past, something done yesterday. Yesterday as in past. It does not mean that just yesterday. It means in the past. Something of the yesterday means something which has already done and over. With every passing day, it would become remote. Remote means it would fade away from my mind. And he's thinking about that. Yes, he's feeling bad. And then what would remain? Would my memories fade away slowly? Or fade slowly away? He's asking us, or is asking himself the question, that would my memories fade? Would I ever forget that I had climbed the Everest? Would now I can remember everything, he says. I can remember everything from beginning to end. What difficulty came, who fell down, everything I can remember, where my leg slipped. But will these memories fade away, he says? Will they all slowly fade away? Fade away means disappear or move away or vanish from my mind. And that thought makes him feel very, very sad about the whole affair, about the whole thing, about the climbing to the mountain. All these thoughts led me to question myself as why people climb mountains. These thoughts, all these kind of thoughts about me forgetting about it, will I ever forget that I have climbed Everest? So all these kind of thoughts led him. So he began to think, why do people climb mountains? It is not easy to answer the question. The simplest answer would be, others have said, because it is there. Simplest answer is, because it is there, so we climb it. That's the simplest answer. It presents great difficulties. The mountain itself presents great difficulties. Man takes delight in overcoming obstacles. The obstacles in climbing a mountain are physical. A climb to the summit means endurance, persistence, and willpower. The demonstration of these physical qualities is no doubt exhilarating, as it was for me also. Exhilarating means very, very exciting. So he says, man takes delight in overcoming obstacles. Yes, man likes challenges. Otherwise, our life becomes very, very mundane, very, very boring. Same thing every day. Get up in the morning, brush your teeth, wear your uniform, sit in front of the mobile phone or the laptop, get ready for online classes, Zoom classes. All that becomes very, very mundane. Mundane means something that happens every day as a routine. So what does man want? Man as in human beings. Don't take it wrong. Man means human beings, not only men. It means, I'm saying man, not men. If I say men, it means only men. But when I say man, it means mankind or human beings. So human beings take delight in overcoming obstacles. We enjoy, human beings enjoy difficulties, enjoy challenges. And that is why maybe this is one challenge that is very, very difficult to climb. And that is why maybe man wants to climb Everest or to conquer Everest. So a climb to the Everest means endurance, your willpower, your power to resist or persist or to keep going on, your strength, how strong you are, your persistence, never giving up attitude. You can't go halfway and say, oh, I'm tired, I'm going back down. You can't say that. That would be not being persistent. You need to be persistent. You need to be continuing what you have set out for. You need to continue that and get to the top or be successful. Never leave anything halfway. The demonstration of these physical qualities is no doubt exhilarating, as it was for me. It was very, very exciting for him also. He loved it. He loved climbing the mountain. I have a more personal answer to this question. What question? Why do people climb mountains? That is a question that he's asking. Why do people climb mountains? And so he says, I have another answer for this. People say, because it is there, so we climb it. But HPS Ahluwalia says, I have a different answer. From my childhood, I have been attracted by mountains. I had been miserable, lost when away from mountains and the plains. Mountains are nature at its best. Their beauty and majesty pose a great challenge, and like many, I believe that mountains are a means of communion with God. So he has a different answer. While people say, oh, the mountain is there, so we climb it. He has a different answer. He says, since my childhood, I have been attracted to mountains and to the beauty of nature. And he says, mountains are the best thing that God has made, that nature has, the best thing. Their beauty and majesty, they look very, very royal, like how a king looks, no, when he's walking down. A king walking and me walking, a man walking will be two different things. A king walks very, very royally. Just by one look at him, you will know that he is the king. The way they walk, they're very, very majestic. Yes, some horses are also very, very majestic. The way they walk, you know that they are of the highest breed. So I believe that mountains are a means of communion with God. Communion, COMMUNION, communion means a state or feeling of close relationship with God. You feel like you're communicating. Communion comes from the word communicating. So it's like communicating with God. Once you climb this mountain, you are on the summit. You are very, very close to God. You are talking to God. You are communicating with God. This is what HPS Ahluwalia feels. While for others, they say the mountain is there, so we climb it. But for HPS Ahluwalia, this was the climb to the summit was a completely different thing for him, to climb the Mount Everest. He really looked forward to climbing it. So in the previous paragraph, we came to know that HPS Ahluwalia feels that mountains are a means of communion with God. Okay, so that is over. Once having granted this, the question remains, why Everest? Why not some other mountain? Why not Mount K2? Why not the Alps? Why Mount Everest? Because it is the highest, the mightiest, and has defied many previous attempts. Because this mountain is the highest mountain, the mightiest mountain, and it has defied many previous attempts. Means many people have tried to climb it, many people have failed, many people have died on the way up or coming down. People have not been successful, and that is why this poses a great challenge for mountaineers like HPS Ahluwalia, because it is one of the highest and the mightiest mountains. And as you know, in the previous paragraphs we did, man likes to face challenges, to overcome challenges. It takes the last ounce of one's energy. Ounce means here, every bit. It takes every bit. You need to be very, very strong to be climbing Mount Everest. Climbing Mount Everest is not a matter of days. You can't say, oh, next month I'm going to climb Mount Everest. No, it's a matter of years. For years, you have to undergo training. And then only they will allow you. Otherwise, just as you just touch the mountain, you are finished. You are dead with exhaustion, with tiredness. You have to build your body. You have to build it to be able to face all the problems that come to you. You have to build your mind mentally, physically, spiritually. You have to be very, very strong to be climbing Mount Everest. It's no joke. Yes, because it will take every ounce of your energy, of your strength. It is a brutal struggle with rock and ice. Brutal. It is ruthless. It doesn't care for you. The Mount Everest is not kind to you. It won't be kind to you. It won't say, okay, bacha, you come here and climb Mount Everest. It won't say that. It won't say, I'll help you. Come on, I'll pull you up. No. It is brutal. You will have to face all difficulties. Once taken up, it cannot be given up halfway. Even when one's life is at stake. Once taken up, once you start climbing this Mount Everest, you cannot say, oh, Baba, I give up. I am going back down. You cannot say that. You will have to go up, because it's not you alone. It's not a matter of you alone climbing. It's a matter of an expedition of many climbing, many people climbing from different countries, climbing together. It may be from your own country or people from different countries all going together as one. You can't think of traveling or going up alone. You have to go in a group. You need other people with you in the group for moral support, for helping you climb here, climb there, pulling you up, pushing you down. You need someone with you. So everyone's life is at stake, is in danger. The passage back is as difficult as the passage onwards. Like I told you, going up is as difficult as coming down. It's not easy coming down. Sometimes coming down is even more difficult than climbing up. Yes, but the writer says the passage up is as difficult, same difficulty is there in going up and coming down. You can't leave everyone up there and tell them, okay, bye-bye, I'm going down. You can't do that. You will have to come down as a group. And then when the summit is climbed, there is the exhilaration, that excitement. Once you have reached the top, that excitement comes into you. The joy of having done something, the sense of a battle fought and won. It seems like you have just gone to the battlefield, fought with the enemy and come back. You will feel success like in that way, like you have conquered your enemy. You will feel that. That feeling will come into you. There is something of victory and of happiness, something of victory that you have accomplished something, that you have won something, and also of happiness. These two things come to your mind once you have reached the top. Glimpsing a peak in the distance. Glimpsing means just having a look, a quick look at a peak in the distance. There are now, Mount Everest does not stand alone there. It's not just one mountain and going up. No, there are many other mountains at the side of it. If you see pictures of it, you'll see many other smaller mountains. It is these mountains that you climb up and you reach Mount Everest. And far away from Mount Everest also, there are mountains, small mountains, shorter mountains. So, standing up here, glimpsing, he says, glimpsing a peak in the distance, I saw one small peak in the distance, he says, I get transported to another world. Means, does he go to another world? No, his mind goes over to another world. Like many of you during class, when we used to have class in the school, many of you suddenly, I'll see you. Your eyes, your body is in the class, but your eyes are far away somewhere. Yes, you get transported. So as he's standing in the peak, he experiences a change within himself. Something is changing within himself. He feels that. Like I told you, that the very climb to the Everest can change a person. So he also experiences that change, which can only be called mystical. Mystical is something spiritual. Something spiritual. By its beauty, aloofness, might, ruggedness, and the difficulties encountered on the way, the peak draws me to it, and Everest did. It is a challenge that is difficult to resist. So he calls this mountain mystical, something very, very religious, something very divine. And by its beauty, aloofness means indifferent in the sense it doesn't care who you are, what you are. Yes, it doesn't care about you. Its might, it's so huge. Its ruggedness, it's not simple, it's not a simple mountain. It's very, very rugged. Some rocks coming out here and there, and you can get hurt. Once you fall down means you can break your head on the rocks. So it is very, very rugged. Rugged means it's full of rocks. And the difficulties encountered on the way, and the difficulties that you come across as you are going up or even coming down. The peak draws me to it. The peak that he can see from there, it's drawing him. The other peak that is, it's like telling him, come to me. Yes, it's drawing him to it. And Everest did. In the same way, Everest had called him. It seemed to him that Everest was talking to him and calling him, come and climb me, it seemed. It is a challenge that is difficult to resist. Some challenges are very, very difficult to resist. Means if someone is challenging you, you will say, yes, I will take this challenge. You will not be able to say, no, I don't want this challenge. Some challenges are very, very difficult to resist, to not do it. Yes, it's very difficult not to do the challenge when somebody is challenging you. And in this case, the mountain, it seemed Mount Everest was challenging HPS Ahluwalia. It was beckoning him or calling him and telling him, come and climb me if you can. And of course, HPS Ahluwalia, the adventurer or the mountaineer that was there in his heart, he took this challenge. He took up this challenge and he decided to climb it. And of course, he came out very, very successful. He was indeed happy climbing the Mount Everest. He came back a different person altogether. So I hope the lesson is clear so far. So don't forget, this lesson is by HPS Ahluwalia. The video that I sent you yesterday, have a look. You can see how he looks now. Now he's become very, very old. Yes, he's become very old now. But he used to be very, very strong, very physically fit. And that you have to be to climb Mount Everest. No weak person can climb Mount Everest. Your heart has to be stable. Your body has to be stable. You need to have very good heart condition. It should be a very, very healthy heart. You cannot be fat. You need to be strong to climb this mountain. And that is what made him successful. His will to do it. Okay. So that's all for today. I'll end here. In the next class, I will complete this lesson. If you have any doubts, please let me know. Okay. You may be having some doubts. Let me know. Okay then. Bye-bye. Take care.